Never before had the Bergsons seen, nor had they heard, such a vast trove of myth and legends. They were so mesmerized by Apon's storytelling that they spent the whole night transfixed as her audience.
Come on.
Can the body endure the mind's gamble? Dreams come true in there. Standing at the gate of the great edifice of Anaisarava, the Bergsons remembered that description. What dreamt the spirit of dreams in his slumber? The answers were near. not-so-innocent game of chance and memory. Trembled near constantly, only calming at the touch of stone.
Thank you.
A curious automaton rummaged through a pile of scrap. It was fully machine, but more human than its hostile ilk, appearing as an innocent little girl. What was such a fragile child doing alone down here? Laughing and shaking the small girl, just like any other bully. And a Bergson knows how to deal with bullies. With the common foe defeated, the little automaton's trust was earned. Dust and decay hung in the stale air. The man sat motionless. The machine called out, but the silence could not reply. Nothing remained for the little automaton in the hollow room. It was all alone. Thank you. Magma in the distance acted as lights for the city. In the center lay Anai Sarava, the intelligent, trapped by his own creation, the final key to the mountain god.
Thank you.
steps were taken without regret, for it was never possible to change a destiny unknown. Water never surfaced, stuck behind two inoperative pumps out of reach. The man warned that both pumps needed to be activated soon after each other. One activate. Now to the other in haste. The Bergs had to start again. First machine began to move. cold breath as hell's. Air soon expelled in exultant shouts as clean water once again returned to those most in need. Relic of yesterday's ambitions, still potent. Gears continued to crank on in the distance, for the city must survive.
Thank you.
now even more soulless than before, without life, and as if none had ever existed within the gears, and a new road forward opened with the jewel of life. Bergsons stood at the gates of a nigh Sarabar, with caution dictated, going back and informing the others. Were they cursed? The more they moved ahead, the more the corruption came forth. Blocked from light, everything withers. The Bergsons wondered what dangers could lie ahead still. She did not speak, just sat there in silent sorrow. And try as they might, the family could not console little automatons.